ಒಂದ್ ಸಲ ಕ್ವಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡೋಣ. ಸೊ ಇವತ್ತು ಇವತ್ತಿನ ತರಗತಿಯ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್, ಪ್ರೆಪೊಸಿಷನ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಹಾಗೂ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಬ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಈ ತರಗತಿಯ ಈ ಒಂದು ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ನ ವಿನ್ಯಾಸ ಹೇಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ನಾಲ್ಕು ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಪ್ರತಿ ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ. ಸೊ ಪ್ರತಿ ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ಸ್. ದೆನ್ ನಾವು ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ವಿ ಲರ್ನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಅ ರೀಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ಸೋ ಫಾರ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫನ್. ಸೊ ಫನ್ ವಿತ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ರಿಡಲ್ಸ್, ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಒಂದು ಎಂಟರ್ಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂಲಕ ಫನ್ ವಿತ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಚೆಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ.
Yesterday is a history. Tomorrow is a mystery. But today is a gift. Hence, it's called the present. Good morning, friends. This is Kriti. I wish to pass each moment of my life meaningfully. I live in the present, but I love the past. I love the nostalgia. I like reminiscing about the time in the past. This fills me with pleasure. I'm also a planner. All this reminiscing helps me to plan for the things that the future holds. When I am remembering and reminiscing about the time that has passed, it is in future tense, past tense. When he talks about today, it is in present tense. And when I plan and prepare for the future, it is in future tense. Today, we will be discussing about lots of activities. But to get to those activities, we need to open the locked doors, which will lead us to them. But first, we need the key. The key is with one of the three doorkeepers. To get the key from them, we need to talk to them. But there is something peculiar about them. Let's ask a couple of questions and understand what is peculiar in them. And then also try to guess who might have the key. Let me check by asking each of them this question. What is your name?
My name was Past Man.
My name is Present Man.
My name will be Future Man.
Interesting. Will you help me?
I had helped you.
I am helping you.
I will help you.
Interesting. They surely talk in a peculiar manner. Let me just ask them who has the key. Do you have the key? But I cannot see their answers. Can you all imagine how they might have answered? If you guys have imagined their answers, then you people already know who has the key. Please help me to know who actually has the key by choosing your options in the upcoming poll question. Everybody, get ready for the poll question now. The question is appearing on your screen now. So our friends have said the key is with present door guard. Yes, friends, you're all right. Good job, friends. Thank you for helping me find the key for the door. Now, let me open the door and go inside the world of activities. Hey, Vivek.
Hi, Kruti.
What are you doing here?
Kruti, I was stuck here in the world of activities.
Oh, so you are very familiar with the activities here. Can you help me know more about these activities?
Yes, Kruti, it's my pleasure. Come, I will introduce you to many such activities. Kruti, here is a wonderful game. Do you know this game?
No, Vivek. Can you please help me understand this game?
Yes, please. You start by creating a grid on the board like this. On the top, we have a bunch of pronouns. To our left, we have a bunch of verbal phrases. And player playing on this grid must first choose a cell inside the grid. That cell will lead to its corresponding pronoun and corresponding verbal phrase. The player now should make use of both the pronoun and the verbal phrase and create a sentence. But that sentence should be in either of the tenses only. The teacher can choose the tense. Thus, the participant should create his sentence using the pronoun and the verbal phrase in the tense that the teacher has declared. The same steps can be repeated in the past tense round, present tense round, and the future tense round.
Vivek, can you give me an example?
Sure, Kriti. Let me take a word from the pronoun grid, she, and meet friends, a verbal phrase. Can you frame a sentence by using this into a past tense?
Will the sentence be, she met friends?
Yes, you're absolutely right, Kriti. Now let us move to the next game. Kriti, what do you see here?
This looks something very similar to what I saw previously. But only thing that I can see as a difference is something is on the hand. What is that?
Kriti, have you ever seen a wristband?
Yes.
This is another activity in the same manner, and this is called the tense band activity. The tense bands are nothing but a roll of paper wrapped around the wrist of a player like any wristband. This band will have three icons on it, each representing the three tenses, that is present, past, and the future. The player can randomly rotate the band to arrive at any tense. That will be the tense that the whole class will play for that round. Learners can be engaged in making personalized tense bands within the classroom to bring out creativity. Rotate the band, choose the tense, pick a cell, change the tense.
Wow, that sounded very interesting, Vivek.
Kriti, come, let's move on to another activity. This is another interesting game, which we call roll the dice, pick and change. Here the players roll the dice, which has the names of the tenses on its each side. The fourth side will have the words roll again. The learners roll these dice and consider the tense depending on what the side the dice rolls facing up. Then the learners pick any sentence from the ice cream stick and try to change those sentences into that tense. Kriti, let us play by taking an example.
Sure, Vivek.
If I take the future tense by rolling the dice and give you a sentence called Ibrahim performed on stage, what will be the future tense of that sentence?
I think it will be Ibrahim will perform on stage.
Yes, you got the point. In the same way, we can continue the game, Kriti. This activity blends in the kinesthetic of rolling the dice and choosing the tense. Kriti, now let's move on to another transaction idea. In this activity, the participants start by standing on the line drawn. The line represents the present tense. The area in the front of the line would be the future tense, and the area behind the line would be the area of the past tense. The teacher starts by reading a sentence. If the participant thinks the sentence is in future, then he jumps forward into the future tense area. If the sentence turns out to be in the past tense, then the participants jump behind the line into the past tense area. This wow. helps. This helps kinesthetic approach of learning Kruti, where learners listen to commands or directions and respond using their bodily movements. How is it, Kruti?
This is interesting, Vivek.
Let us summarize what we have learned so far. We know that every event happens in either of the three tenses broadly. If an event has already happened, it belongs to the past tense, and we use words like did, was, were, had, etc. When an event is still in process and is still going on, we refer to it in present tense, is, are, am, doing, having, and so on. If an event is yet to commence and yet to happen, we refer to it in future tense and use words like will, shall.
Thank you, Sonia.
Welcome, Kruti.
Vivek, do you like riddles?
I love playing riddles, Kruti.
Okay. Now that we have reached our checkpoint of fun, let's have some fun with riddles. Okay. I have a riddle for you.
Yes, please.
It says, I have three letters, but pronounced as one letter. I am double. I am single. I am black, blue, and gray. I am a part of your body, and I am the first thing that people see in you. What am I?
Sorry, I'm unable to recognize that, Kruti. Could you please give me some options?
Sure, Vivek. Here are your options. Take your time and look at each word and try to think and guess which word might be the answer.
Oh my God, there are more than 5 to 6 options. Kruti, I'm very sorry. I can't identify the right answer even now. Let's ask our friends, Kruti. I need their advice.
Sure, Vivek. Dear friends, Vivek is unable to guess the answer. Will you all please help Vivek to find the answer? Please let us know your answer through the polling question that will be appearing on your screen now. So many of our friends said the answer is I. What do you think, Vivek, now?
Even I is the answer, but I don't know why they have selected I, Kruti. Could you please explain that to me?
Sure, Vivek. Eyes can be black and some eyes are blue and brown as well. The letters in the word I are three, but we have only one pronunciation of I. So that's why the answer is I.
Oh, my friends are really intelligent and clever. Thank you, friends.
Vivek?
Yes, Kruti?
I can see some door over here.
Yes. Come, let me introduce you to my friend, Sushil.
Hi, Vivek.
How come you here and what is this room?
Yes, Vivek. This is my room and my room is the room of prepositions. Come, let me take you both inside and let us discuss some prepositions, shall we?
Yes, Sushil.
So this, Vivek, is my room of prepositions. Prepositions, as we know, are those words that tell us about the position of objects. Like here, prepositions are helping us convey that some things are kept on the bed, some things are kept on the floor, and some are kept beside the shelves, and etc. Let us now play a game, Vivek, shall we?
Okay, Sushil.
This is a game of find the object. I will ask you to find a couple of objects in this room and then you will find the object for me. Actually, I was getting ready to attend this training, but I'm unable to find my shoe. Can you help me find my shoe, Vivek? Where is my shoe?
Sushil. The shoe is under the bed.
Yes, I see that now. I found my shoe under the bed. Thank you so much, Vivek.
Yeah.
Hey, Kriti, can you help me out with a green book that I need to pack in my bag? I don't know where I've kept it. Please find my green book.
Sushil, your green book is below the red book.
Oh, yeah, there it is. There is my green book. Thank you, Kriti. So now I'm ready. So let's continue. And now I'll discuss with you some common prepositions. So these are some common prepositions that we use every day. Above, on, in, under, below, beside. We followed the cat, and the cat helped us in showing some common prepositions. But Vivek, look at your screen right now. What can you see?
Sushil, I can see some basic shapes that we use in day-to-day life, like rectangles, circle, triangle, etc.
Yes, Vivek, you're right. So these are some common shapes, and we have just discussed some common prepositions also, haven't we?
Yes.
So let us use both the common shapes as well as some common prepositions, and let's do an activity. Teachers, I would like you to join Vivek and take part in this activity by taking that pen and paper that you had kept ready. We will have a sketching session now. I will instruct all of you to sketch. I'll tell you what to draw and where to draw. I will be using these common shapes and the common prepositions, and we will sketch together. Vivek, are you ready with your pen and paper?
Yes, Sushil. I'm exciting and I'm waiting for an opportunity to draw a sketch.
Very good, Vivek. That's very wonderful of you. So let us start by drawing a triangle in the middle of the page. I hope all the teachers are also ready with the pen and paper. So let us all start by drawing a triangle in the middle of the page. Mind the prepositions and mind the shapes. Next, let us draw a small circle inside the triangle. So first, we draw a triangle in the middle of the page, and now we have drawn a small circle inside the triangle. Next, let us draw a square below the triangle, but remember that this square should be as big as the triangle itself. We are now drawing a square which is as big as the triangle itself, and we are drawing the square just below the triangle. Wonderful. Let us now draw a vertical rectangle inside that square on the base of the square. So what are we doing now here? At the base of the square, we are drawing a small vertical rectangle. Very nice. So the last thing to be done here is we will draw two identical curved lines. So we'll draw two identical curved lines beside each other, just below the square. Just below the square that we have drawn, we'll draw two curved lines beside each other. Wonderful. I hope everybody has drawn. Vivek, have you been following the instructions properly?
Yes, I'm curiously following the instructions. I'm eager to show my picture as Sushil.
Okay, Vivek. So I hope all the teachers have also completed their sketch. Let us now look at what Vivek has drawn, shall we? Vivek, please show us your sketch.
Sushil, see, this is what I drew.
Wonderful, Vivek. You have come up with the sketch of a house.
Yeah.
I see that you have followed all the prepositions properly. You have placed all the shapes at the right place.
Thank you. Thank you, Sushil.
Wonderful. Okay. I hope even all the teachers, all my teacher friends have also drawn similar images. This was wonderful, isn't it? Exciting. Let us try again. Let us try to draw another sketch. Okay. Vivek and all the teachers, let us start by drawing a large circle in the middle of the page this time. So this time we'll draw a very large circle in the middle of the page. I think you're done. Now, we will draw an inverted triangle. Remember a triangle? Invert the triangle. We'll draw this inverted triangle over the top of the circle that we have already drawn. We'll draw an inverted triangle over the top of that circle. But mind you, only one of its corners must be inside the circle and the other two corners must be on the outside. We have drawn a circle. Now, on top of that circle, we are drawing an inverted triangle, but only one corner of the triangle is inside that circle and the other two corners of the triangle are outside of that circle. I think everybody is done. Vivek, you're done with the second instruction?
Yes, Sushil, I am there. Let's move on.
Very good. So now, let us draw two small circles beside each other inside the triangle. So remember the triangle that we have just drawn, the inverted triangle? We'll draw two very small circles beside each other inside that triangle. Very nice. So let us now draw two medium-sized circles on the upper two corners of the triangle. Remember, these are the upper two corners which are not inside the circle. We'll draw two medium-sized circles on these upper two corners of the triangle, the inverted triangle. Now we'll draw two small straight lines on either sides of the large circle. Remember the large circle that we had drawn in the first instruction? We'll draw two small straight lines on the either sides of the large circle. Yes. Now we'll finish this sketch by drawing two very small parallel lines, parallel straight lines on the bottom of the large circle. These are just two small parallel straight lines on the bottom of the large circle. Vivek, are you done with your sketch?
Yes, Sushil, it's over now.
Very good. Before I ask you to show me your sketch, look at your screen now. Can you see the yellow colored words?
Yes, Sushil. I see some words like in, top, inside, outside, beside, on, bottom. What are they, Sushil?
These are the prepositions, Vivek.
Oh, right, right. Now I got it.
Yeah, I hope you have been following the prepositions correctly, because now you are supposed to show me your sketch. Show me your sketch.
No, Sushil. My friend is also eagerly writing along with me, and she was also drawing. I asked Kruti to show this time.
Okay, Kruti. Then let me see your sketch. Let us all see Kriti's sketch, shall we?
Sushil, I got a big fat rat.
Oh, wonderful, Kriti. But I wonder, why is your rat so fat?
It's the effect of lockdown, Sushil.
Wonderful, Kriti. Vivek, I think it's your turn now. All the teachers would like to see your sketch as well.
Sushil, I didn't get this picture because I got this picture, Sushil.
Oh-ho. But why is your rat sleeping, Vivek?
Sushil, my rat is sleeping because it is a time of corona and it is taking rest inside the house.
Oh, but that's a nice reason that you gave. But I can clearly see that you have failed to follow the prepositions in the right way.
Yeah, sorry, Sushil. I'll recorrect myself next time.
No worries. Yeah. So let us now look at some more ideas. So teachers, just like the activity that we just experienced, you can all do this in your classroom using different shapes. And as and when you think your students are actually getting better at prepositions, you can use more colorful and more intriguing shapes and use more and more complicated prepositions to make them draw colorful and more complicated shapes in the classroom.
These activities are fine in a classroom for majority of the class, Sushil. But in a classroom, what if there are different with children needs?
Yes, Sonia, that's a wonderful concern. That is true. As a teacher and as a facilitator, it becomes our responsibility to prepare an activity with everyone in mind and everyone's learning in mind. So here, teachers, what we can do is we can use cutout of shapes which visually challenged learners can touch and feel and identify the shapes and then follow the same instructions and carry out the activity with everyone else, just like everyone else. Alternatively, sandpapers can be used to cut out the shapes that we have mentioned, and which this will provide a good tactile feel to all the learners, who can then touch the surface and the edges, identify the shape, and then play with the prepositions.
Thank you, Sushil.
Till now, we have used prepositions to identify the location of a new object. Now, let us look at a new idea which can be played as a group or a team activity. This can be played in a classroom with all the students participating in it. Sonia, would you like to participate in this activity?
Yes, of course, Sushil.
Sure, Sonia. So let me start by drawing asking you to draw a fish bowl in the center of the board.
I would draw a table on the board and make the fish bowl sit on it.
Good, Sonia. That would be your action when I ask you to draw a fish bowl on the table. Yes. Okay. Good. Now, what if I ask you, tell you that the table is in between two chairs?
Okay.
And I would continue by telling you that the panda is behind the table and there is a cat under the table. And here you would come and place a panda, draw a panda, and draw a cat under the table.
Yes, sir.
This is a group activity where individual learner can be encouraged to reinforce their understanding about prepositions by contributing their understanding in the form of turn-based activity teachers. Okay. So Sonia, let me show you another activity.
Sushil.
What do you see on your screen?
I can see something that's look like a train.
Yes. So we like to call it the preposition train. So you start from the first compartment of the train. You roll the dice and move along the different compartments by solving one question at a time. Example, let me ask you a question. So imagine, Sonia, that you have started from the first compartment. What if you are on the cell which reads, I like to sit dash Sahana. What would be your answer?
I like to sit beside Sahana.
Very good, Sonia. Wonderful. So now you get the chance to move to the next cell. Good. So teachers, in the same way, this activity can be played out in the classroom floor as well by drawing series of boxes using chalk pieces.
To bring kinesthetic element to this game, the learners can also hop through the boxes just like in Kunte Bille or hopscotch game.
Yes, wonderful idea, Sonia. We can do that as well.
Thank you, Sushi.
Yeah, this reminds me of one thing. Hey, Kriti, I remember that you had won a jackpot recently. What all did you purchase with that money?
Yes, Sushi, I won a jackpot last week and I purchased some jewelry for myself and some mobile laptop and a tablet. And I also gifted a scooter for Vivek and a TV for Sonia and some house appliances.
Wonderful. That's so great to hear. Okay. I wonder, where did you place your laptop in your house?
I kept my laptop on the table, Sushi.
Okay. And assuming this is your room, this is your house, where did you place the refrigerator that you bought?
I just placed it in the kitchen. And this refrigerator is a gift for you. It will be reaching you soon, okay?
Thank you so much, Kriti. That's so sweet of you. So in the similar fashion, teachers, students can be made to come up with a list of objects and then they can draw or sketch their own room or house on the notebook or even on the board and then place those objects in the respective places where they want to place using the right preposition. So now we have reached our checkpoint of fun again. So in this checkpoint of fun, let us play with some more prepositions and play the activity, find the object again. Yeah, so Vivek.
Yes, Sushil.
I would like you to look for a wooden horse in this image. Can you find a wooden horse in the image?
Oh my God, there are so many tools and articles here, so many toys. I'm unable to find that, Sushil.
Yeah. Teachers, please do follow the instructions as well and keep looking for the objects. This time, look for the wooden horse and answer to this question, which reads, the wooden horse is dash the paint canvas. Vivek?
Yes, Sushil.
Did you find the wooden horse and can you answer to this question now?
Sushil, no, even I didn't find this time. Shall we have a polling question for our friends?
Sure. So teachers, I hope you have been paying attention and looking for the wooden horse. If you have found the wooden horse, look for it and look at the question, the wooden horse is dash the paint canvas. Use the right preposition in the upcoming poll question. Use that poll question that's coming on your screen right now. Vivek, let's see what all the participants have answered.
Yeah.
Can you see what they have answered?
I see many of them have answered, but where is it, Sushil? I want to know that in this picture.
Yeah. Yes. So let's see where the wooden horse actually is, shall we?
Yes.
There it is.
Oh, it is right behind the paint canvas, right?
Yes, Vivek. So 77% of all the teachers correctly identified that the wooden horse was indeed behind the paint canvas.
Okay, thank you very much, friends. Thank you.
Yes. Okay, let's move on to the next object then.
Yes.
This time, Sonia, I want you to find a toy truck.
Yes, Sushil.
Can you find a toy truck for me? And answer to this question.
I'm searching. Sorry, Sushil. I'm not able to find it.
Sure. No worries, Sonia. I think even you would require to take the help of all the participants then. So sure. Participants, are you all ready to help Sonia this time? Try to answer to this question. The toy truck is dash the conveyor belt. But before that, look for the toy truck. If you have found the toy truck, then use the right preposition and answer. The poll question is coming up on your screen right now. Hey, Sonia, look there. 64% of our participants are telling us that the toy truck is under the conveyor belt.
Oh. Where is the toy truck, Sushil? Let me see this.
Yes, let's find out, Sonia. There it is. The toy truck is indeed under the conveyor belt. Good job, teachers. Well done.
Thank you, teachers. Thank you, Sushil.
Yes, Sonia. Better luck next time, okay?
Okay, Sushil, sure.
Okay. So last and the best object now. Let me see who will do this. Kriti. Yeah. Can you find a dart board for me in this image?
Okay, you're looking for a dart board, is it?
Remember, the dart board is white and red in color. You'll have to look very hard.
I think I found it. Do you want me to show it to you?
Sure. Why not? Will you show it to us?
Yes. So the dart board is here. It's beside the sketch of the bear.
Very nice, Kriti. Good girl. Wonderful. So it is the time for homework, teachers. We have till now covered some common prepositions. We haven't. But these are a couple of more prepositions. Over, across, under, and beneath. The task for all the teachers is to look for the meaning, similarities, and differences between these prepositions. I know most of you already know the differences and similarities here, but those teachers who are curious about the answer, they can wait for the post-reading material that will be shared with you later today.
Sushil, let's see what we have learned about prepositions now. Preposition helps us in knowing the object and its location or position with respect to its surroundings. Prepositions that we have discussed here helps us paint the picture of a scene by telling us the physical location of the object in its surrounding through verbal medium or text medium. Hey Vivek, what is this door?
Kriti, come. Let us continue the journey in this world of activity. I'll introduce you to meet the articles now. My friends, the articles have been waiting to meet us since morning. And introduce you to all of them. I'm sorry that the articles could not be here with us in person. They have extended their apologies for not being here with us physically. All we might know, they belong to the world of words. They are busy solving different problems of words from both the consonant community and the vowel community.
Okay, now let us meet Miss Anne. She is the most finicky of the three articles. She is a kind-hearted article just as the other two, but is a bit choosy. If you are a word and if you want to make friends with her, you better start with a vowel. She likes to hang around with words that start with vowels, and going with her popularity among the vowels, she's also the chairman of the Vowel Association. This is Mr. A. Mr. A is an always trending celebrity among the biggest group in the world, that is the consonants. If you are one among those million of words which start with a consonant, then he is your guy to hang out with. Between Miss Anne and Mr. A, he is currently leading with the largest number of followers, all thanks to the huge number of words that starts with consonant.
This is Mr. The. He is the godfather of the articles and enjoys the utmost respect in the community of words. He is also one among the nicest gentlemen. He has such respect in the world that in order to make friends with him, you need a recommendation letter from either A or N. Only if you prove that you are friends with any one of these two articles that you are allowed to meet Mr. The. In the world of words, he is currently leading with the largest number of followers because the followers of both A and N follow Mr. The.
Vivek, do you know Mr. The has some exclusive friends?
Oh, is it, Kruti? I didn't know about that. I'm confused about these three articles. Please explain me more about this.
Sure, Vivek. The three articles can be divided as definite and indefinite articles. A and an are the indefinite articles and the is the definite article. When the indefinite articles A and an refer to something, they don't tell us specifically who they are referring to. But the definite article the makes it specific. The indefinite article A is used for words starting with a consonant or consonant sound, as in a cup, a watermelon, or a man, etc. The indefinite article an is used before words that start with vowel or vowel sound, as in an umbrella, an orange, or an ant, etc. The definite article the, on the other hand, is used to refer to the same object that A or an have already specified, as in the cup, the watermelon, the man, the orange, etc. The vowel or the consonant from which the word starts does not affect the use of the.
Kruti, but I remember that you said there are some exclusive friends for Mr. The. Who are they?
Vivek, these exclusive friends of the are rare and one of a kind things. Such things usually don't go with A or an, but are always accompanied by the, hence making them unique, as in the Taj Mahal, the universe, the earth, the Mount Everest, the Himalayas, etc.
Oh, fine, Kruti. Thank you very much.
Vivek, let us now go through some transaction ideas for articles. The name of this activity is Teacher Says. This is inspired by the activity Simon Says, which is famous among the teachers of English. Here, the teacher gives instruction to the learners and the learners follow them accordingly. For example, the first instruction could be, teacher says, touch a bag. The learner would run and touch a bag. It can be any bag because the teacher has said a bag which is indefinite and not specific. This activity makes the learner to listen to an instruction in English and react to it physically. The kinesthetic element of the activity makes it a fun activity for learners.
Yeah, Kruti, you know, I have played this game many times in the classroom. But now that you have just explained how this activity is transacted, let's play a game, shall we?
Sure, Vivek.
I will ask you and also my friends to play and participate in this game. The question is, teacher says, if Kashvi is instructed, teacher say, touch a nose, what will Kashvi do? I repeat, if Kashvi is instructed, teacher says, touch a nose, Kashvi do? These are the options. She will touch her nose, she will touch her friend's nose, either of the two above. Shall we ask our friends?
Sure, Vivek. Friends, now you can see the question on your screen as a poll question. I request you all to answer. And I also request you to answer through polling question and not through chat section.
Kruti.
50% of her friends have told that she will touch her nose. And 10% have told she will touch her friend's nose.
Yeah, that is why I too am confused. Please explain me that. What would be the right answer, Kruti?
I think the right answer is either of the two above. Because
why?
Teacher has said touch a nose. And a nose is an indefinite article being used. And it can be any nose. Right?
Oh, fine. Then the answer is either of the two above.
Yes, Vivek.
Okay, thank you, friends. Hope you got the answer.
Let us now recap all that we have discussed about articles, shall we?
Yes, Sushil.
So articles are those special words which help us refer to things that we want to talk about in definite or indefinite way, where the is the definite article and a and an being the indefinite ones. Now, teachers, we reached our checkpoint of fun again. It's time to have some fun watching a video from the movie English Winglish. Let us enjoy the video and then talk about it. So teachers, that was really a good question and a nice video that made us think that if we use the before the United States of America, then why don't we use the when we refer to India? Interesting little puzzle, isn't it?
Yes.
I know some of our participants might already know the answer to this, but to those curious about the answer, again, you can find out the answer to this question in the post-reading material.
Sonia, what are you doing beside the door here?
I was here for some time. Vivek, let us discuss about subject-verb agreement. We go through activities. Here, we have a sentence. I feel something is wrong with this sentence. I don't know what that is.
Yes, even I too don't know, Sonia. I need some explanation about that.
When we look at any sentence, we look for two important things in it. The first being the verb and the second being the subject. The verb in a sentence tells us what is happening in the sentence, whereas the subject gives us the information of who is doing that task.
Yes, Sonia. But you see, in this sentence, we can see that it is the children who are doing the task. and reading the book is the task that is going on, right?
Yes. Let's come back to this sentence. After we have discussed a bit more about what exactly is subject-verb agreement. Now, I will read one sentence. Can you identify the subject and the verb?
Sonia, here in this sentence, he is the subject and singing is the verb.
Very good, Vivek. You are right. Now, the next sentence is, they are singing. Can you identify the subject and the verb?
Sonia, here, they is the subject, singing is the verb. But I can see that the subject here is they and the verb is singing. But notice that are is used in this sentence, unlike the present tense, which was used earlier.
Yes, you are right, Vivek. Now, the next sentence is, the family is singing. Vivek, identify the subject and the verb.
Sonia, here, the family is the subject, singing is the verb. But again, I can see that here, is used again, with the family being the subject and singing being the verb. Curious, Sonia.
Vivek? Let's look at other sentences and try to figure out if the subject and the verb agree in these sentences.
Yes, Sonia.
Look at the first sentence. Rustam and Sohrab is going trekking. Vivek, do you think this sentence is correct?
Sonia, here I see Rustam and Sohrab are subject and going is the verb.
This sentence lacks subject-verb agreement because of the use of is in the sentence. We use is for a singular subject. The sentence would be right if it's read as Rustam is going trekking. But here, we are talking about both Rustam and Sohrab. We ought to use the plural helping verb are, and the sentence should be Rustam and Sohrab are going trekking.
Oh, now I understood, Sonia. Rustam and Sohrab are going trekking.
Yes, Vivek. A good book and a hammock is all the entertainment I need. Vivek, are the subject and the verb in agreement?
Sonia, book and hammock are the subject and need is the verb. But I think something is missing. There is a lack of subject-verb agreement. Could you please explain that?
Sure, Vivek. Because as we had just discussed, if we are talking about plural subjects, then our helping verb need to be plural as well. The correct answer would be a good book and a hammock are all the entertainment I need.
Oh, right, Sonia. As there are two subjects, good book and a hammock, the verb should be are.
Vivek, let me ask some more question. Malik like fish. Can you identify the subject and the verb first?
Yes, I'll do that. Malik is the subject and like is the verb.
Very good, Vivek. You are right. Now, tell me whether the subject and the verb are in agreement?
Sonia, I think there is some confusion and problem in this sentence, but I don't know what that is actually about. Let us ask our friends this time for a chat question. Friends, I request you now to say whether this has the subject-verb agreement by answering yes or no in the chat box.
So teachers, remember, this time we are using the chat box. There is no poll question for this. You are free to go to the chat section, type yes or no, Yes, if you feel that the sentence has subject verb agreement. No, if you feel that the sentence does not have a subject verb agreement. Send your responses. I can already see that most of our participants are answering as no.
Yes, Sushil.
Yeah, the sentence does not have subject verb agreement. Mm-hmm. Yes, almost all the teachers unanimously have been answering as no, that the subject and the verb do not agree in the sentence.
Yes, Sushil.
Sonia, what do you think?
Sushil, I'll help Sonia this time. My friends are absolutely right. There's no subject verb agreement here because, see, Malik is the subject which is in third person and like is in singular form. There is a rule in English which state when there is a third person singular, the verb should be in S form, which states Malik likes fish.
Very good, Vivek. We enjoys horror movies. Vivek, can you identify the subject and the verb?
Sonia, I'll help you. We is the subject, enjoys is the verb.
You are right, Vivek. Now tell me, does this sentence has subject verb agreement?
Sonia, you just taught me earlier, as the rule says, this does not have subject verb agreement because we is the subject which is in plural and enjoys is in S form. But the rule says when there is a plural subject, the verb should be in singular, which states we enjoy horror movies.
That's fine, Vivek. The next sentence is, I either grandpa or my sisters are going to the park. Can you identify the subject and the verb in this sentence?
Sure, Sonia. Grandpa and sister is the subject. Going is the verb.
Excellent, Vivek. You are right. Now tell me, does this sentence have subject and the verb agreement?
Sonia, as rule says, this has subject verb agreement. Because you see, the subject which is nearer to the verb is my sisters, which is in plural form. Verb which is used is are, which is absolutely right. Either grandpa or my sisters or going to the park has subject verb agreement.
Good. The next sentence is, either my sisters or grandpa is going to the park. Vivek, does this sentence has subject and the verb agreement?
Sonia, I am tired of answering all your questions. I want my friends to take part this time. Friends, please help me to see whether this has the subject verb agreement through a poll question by answering yes or no.
Wonderful participants.
Wow. Friends, I'm very happy that you have predicted the right answer. Either my sisters or grandpa is going to the park agrees the subject verb agreement because the nearest subject, which is grandpa, is in singular form. So the helping verb is, and the answer states either my sisters or grandpa is going to the park is right. Thank you, friends.
Now, coming back to the sentence that we started from, using all the things that we have discussed till now, we can see that because there are two subjects here and both doing the same task of reading, the sentence should read, we are reading.
Yes. Now I understood, Sonia. The answer is we are reading, which has the subject verb agreement.
Let us venture into discussing some transaction ideas for subject verb agreement and going in line with the name agreement. This is an activity named Samjhota Express. Vivek, do you know what is Samjhota Express?
Sonia, I think samjhota means agreement. Are we talking about subject verb agreement in this activity?
Yes, Vivek, you are right. Here, the learners hop from one box to another, and when they are in each box, the teacher reads them a sentence. The learners should then identify if the subject and the verb agree in that sentence and answer accordingly to the teacher. If the answer is right, the teacher will ask the learner to hop forward. If the answer is wrong, then the participant goes back into the previous box. This is another idea where the learners take part in kinesthetic activity and learn language. Got it, Vivek?
Yes, Sonia. Thank you very much. It was a wonderful activity.
Vivek, can you tell me what do you see in this grid?
Sonia, I'm very poor at maths. I see some numbers and there are some grids and boxes. What is this actually about?
This is an activity with lot of visual elements. Here, the learners give the right answer relating to singular pronouns or plural pronouns and use colors and numbers to complete a drawing. If and only if the learners get the answer right, can they color the right boxes and reveal the hidden mystery picture. Got it, Vivek?
This is one wonderful activity where the children play and also learn numbers through some hidden words and reveal the answer. Fine activity, Sonia.
So regarding subject verb agreement, the aspects that we have discussed so far are that we need to look out for three elements to make a sentence right. The first being, look at the subject of that sentence. Then look at what the subject is doing, that is the verb or the helping verb. And then look at how many of those subjects are present in that sentence to make your subject and the verb agree. That concludes our discussions regarding tenses, prepositions, articles, and subject verb agreement, teachers. I hope we all have enjoyed the activities, transaction ideas, as well as the content of discussion. I would draw everybody's attention to some of the learning outcomes that all these activities try to achieve. You can see on your screen learning outcomes that are grade-wise segregated. These are the learning outcomes that our activities try to achieve. These are the learning outcomes with respect to the grades of 6th and 7th. As we have already discussed, Teachopia is the platform where all the content, lesson plans, worksheets, and videos related to all the concepts in grade 4th, 5th, 6th, and 7th are available. So these are the name of the chapters which have these topics that we have been discussing so far. You can find similar activities and more interesting activities on the platform Teachopia once that is available to all.
Thank you, Sushil. ಪ್ರೀತಿಯ ಶಿಕ್ಷಕ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ 1 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ವಿವೇಕ್ ಸರ್, ಸೋನಿಯಾ ಮ್ಯಾಡಮ್, ಕೃತಿ ಮತ್ತು ಸುಶೀಲ್ ಅವರು ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ತುಂಬಾ ಧನ್ಯವಾದ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ.